Hi all and welcome. In this video I'm mainly going to concentrate on pathways of light. So these are illustrations, if you will, of modern Masonic tracing boards, if you will. So we have a being here and he has perhaps transcended up and he has become a light being. Now people are perhaps pillars, as in pillars of society, in an esoteric sense. So here we have a pillar. We also have another one. We usually have the pillars under the sun and the moon. The one under the moon will have a slightly darker color to it. But these pillars are perhaps representative of light. And in this case, you can see that you can actually sort of see through them, see through the light of the pillar, if you will. We also have the light coming from this source here towards the sun. Here we have a progression of light through these spheres. And again, we have a progression of light through the spheres. In this case, it's perhaps emanating from the mouth of this godlike figure up here. Within the St. Andrew's Cathedral in Sydney, we have these references to the zodiac. I'll just quickly show those. And I guess I'm showing these because it sort of shows you that the people who attend these churches don't get told the full story about what's around the churches. Here we have the perhaps the sun in the middle with the 12 houses of the zodiac around the edges here. These are perhaps the fixed houses of the zodiac on the outside. Now up here we have, to this side we have Moses here with his horns, which I'm going to talk about. These tablets here are perhaps representative of lava flow, which also relates to light, but to lava flow. Don't quote me on that, but I'm just putting that out there. So here we have light emanating from an orifice here within this, what is perhaps the sun here. So it's coming from another place, perhaps within the sun and through the sun. Now here we have some what is perhaps fire on the top here, fire on the top of the head. So just keep that in mind as we move along here, and also keep in mind those horns of Moses. Here we have Jesus perhaps transcending up into the sun. Here we have some light emanating from a star in a particular direction, and again, but this time the star is actually within the sun, or a star within a star, or a source from within a source. This is interesting, we have someone in a sun or in a star. Very interesting depiction there. I think it's worth having some knowledge about these things and that they exist. Here we have a figure and he has light perhaps emanating into or out of the head in this fashion. In this, it's almost like a Maltese cross type fashion behind his head. And here again we have this stylistic cross with, and this perhaps depicts light heading into the center here, and then there is perhaps an emanation out. I'm not saying that that is the case. I'm looking at possibilities here of these crosses and light crosses. Here we have Aries and he's holding up this little flagpole here with the Maltese cross on the top, which is kind of glowing. This is a depiction of light, it seems. Light, as we have around the head of Aries here, these crosses of light. Now this figure here I find interesting. He has light coming out of a region where you would expect horns to be. Now, horn, unicorn, unihorn. So horn and corn are very similar. Here we have the cornucopia. And from the cornucopia comes abundance, copious amounts of abundance. And we have the pine cone in this one, and we have it on many of them. Or we might have a pineapple, representative of the pineal gland. We also have the horns on the head here that are perhaps representative of wisdom. Now, I'll get to that, because here we have a cornucopia, and we have gold coins coming out, and the gold perhaps represents enlightenment, gold, and turning your lead into gold, and the gold represents enlightenment. So here we have Baphomet. Now these horns perhaps represent the light going into, it's as if they are antennae or receivers of light, perhaps. and then we have the fornix in the brain, and then from the fornix, and the fornix is perhaps the furnace, as per the information of Bill Donahue, and that perhaps sends the fire out through this part here, through the brain. We also have, Billy here, he is the regimental goat in England. And the same thing, and we have this fire coming through the crown here, coming through the crown. And then we have these parts, this sort of triune part here. We have a triune sort of part here as well. So things to think about, I think. So here we have Aries, the lamb, right in the center here with this light going through these stages, if you will. There are these sort of partitions of what it seems to be like cloud. It's often depicted as some sort of cloud. And then light again. And we get this over and over again. This depiction of these stages of light coming out. Here we have an angel with light emanating from the mouth towards the earth. Now, angels also have instruments like flutes in their mouth, and this is perhaps a representation of light, but also harmony and harmonics also. On churches we have gargoyles. Now, gargoyles are called gargoyles because they gargle water. So that is part of the reason why they are called gargoyles. Now, gargoyles also emit water. Now, water is life-giving, just as light is life-giving. So I'm suggesting that as sort of above where we have angels, down sort of below here, if you will, we have gargoyles on churches. Now, there is perhaps an alchemical aspect to gargoyles as well, and I can't say that I know exactly what it is, but may I suggest that you have, say if you have the combination of fire and water, or heat and water, you get distillation and you get clouds and you get purification of water, and then it may be something along those lines. And also water is a feminine element, if you will, as opposed to the light, which is related to the fire, perhaps, which is more of a male element. So I just thought I would put this out there. So this is perhaps an aspect to gargoyles, along with aspect of them being something that perhaps scares away spirits, if you will. So this is on the side of the St. Patrick's Cathedral in Melbourne. So here is a diagram with an alchemical diagram with light coming down in specific on specific angles, and we also have the clouds here with the waters coming down from the clouds, the moisture, if you will, and here again. So the gargoyles perhaps fit into this equation. So I just thought I'd point that out for now, as that's the information that I know for now. Here we have some water flowing down from this lady here. Combinations of water and fire. And here we have the light flows about this diagram here. The goats with their spiraling horns. It's interesting that spiral, it perhaps has something to do with DNA in part two. And just to finish out, there is Billy, the regimental goat. And here is this horned lady here within the town hall of New South Wales, of Sydney. So that's it for this video. Bye for now. I hope you enjoyed it.